Of course, your nerd ass wants to play chess.
Chess is one of the most influential games of all of history, you uncultured swine. It has stood the test of time and is one of the most respected activities one can participate in.
Quit your yapping, it's fine. I play chess with Brock every now and then, so I've gotten pretty good.
Brock is a child Jesse. How would one get good playing against a child? I know for a fact it is very easy to manipulate Brock.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, it's nothing. Did you really not pick that up?
Whatever, bitch. How are we supposed to all play? Chess is a two-player game and there are three of us.
We could...
What is it, Saul? Why'd you join the call again?
Guys, Kim and I are currently hiding under Howard's wife's bed. She's gone now, but she can come back any minute we need help.
Saul, how the fuck did you get into that predicament?
We decided after finishing with Howard, we'd do it to his wife too. But when we got in here, the bed was empty. We heard her coming, so we quickly hid under the bed. She brought in, you won't believe it, Daniel Wormald, and started going down on him.
I recorded the whole thing to send to Howard.
Imagine getting cucked by Daniel Wormald.
I would say you're one to talk, but yeah, you're right. If Daniel Wormald steals your girl, you might as well do cocaine, then run into an ocean leaving your car on the beach.
Saul, is she's gone, why are you still there?
Well, she's in the bathroom, and Daniel is currently on the other side of the room blasting FNAF music to get ready for, as he calls it, round two.
He lasted 45 seconds and has spent the last 5 minutes doing this, trying to recover.
What do you expect me to do about this, Saul?
I need you to help us. You know the guy? You can say you need to meet with him about a business issue. I don't know, just do something.
Mike, I'll let you chew on my shoulder if you get us out of here.
Well, can't say no to that. It is getting pretty late, and I need to conserve energy for tomorrow's event.
Now, our issue of three players for chess is solved.
Yeah, see you tomorrow, Mike.
See you guys.
Hey, baby, Mr. Funtime is up and ready for action.
Is that seriously the size of his dick? How can he even tell that it's erect?
Gotta go.
Holy shit, Mr. White, what's taking so long? Start the game already.
I was trying to generate a game name that I liked. Unfortunately, you can't choose a custom one.
Why the fuck do you care about the game's name? This is why I should have hosted the game.
It's important, damn it. But I think I found one that I like.
Then, why the fuck is the game not started yet?
Because I'm customizing the background and the pieces and stuff. Get out of my ass.
No one cares about that. Just start the game.
You're always complaining about when I use excuses, so you should be happy I'm doing this because I won't have an excuse just in case I lose, which I won't, but still.
How in the world would you not getting the background you want count as an excuse?
Oh, for God's sake, I'm starting the game. Quit complaining.
Finally. Mr. White, what the fuck are these pieces?
I don't know. I thought they looked kind of cool, that's all.
I can't even tell what the pieces are. How am I supposed to play with this bullshit?
Wow, Jesse. Way to reveal your incompetence. The fact that you don't even know where the pieces lie is a true testament to your level of intellect. Side note, what the fuck were you doing opening with D5?
It's just what my defense is.
What's wrong with E5? Why couldn't you have played like a normal person and done that?
The fact that you're so upset over me playing D5 shows it was the right move.
No, it was just a stupid move. It is simply annoying to White and it doesn't really help Black at all.
If that's the case, then you should be happy. I played that move since apparently it gave you an edge.
Well, as you can see, it did give me an edge. I now have a one-point material lead. A competent player would have actually been able to use D5 against White.
Oh, wow, you have a whole point over me. How will I ever manage to overcome these overwhelming odds?
You're talking sarcastically as if it isn't a big advantage.
Because it's not. How is a single pawn supposed to make a difference? They are meant to be killed. They're so useless.
Jesse, have you never promoted a pawn before? Are you so bad you've seriously never done that?
Obviously, I have bitch, but you rarely promote more than one pawn. And by my count, I still have six left.
Promoting isn't even the pawn's main use. The main use is simply defending your important pieces.
Aha. You just called the other pieces important, implying the pawns aren't.
Jesse, that obviously is not what I meant. They are more important, being worth three material.
Honestly, though, that is a good point about how they defend other pieces.
Thank you, Jesse. I'm glad I have helped you see reason.
I still don't believe one material makes a difference, though.
A fucking course. There is no statistical way you just did that.
What? You've been doing trades this whole game.
Is there some hidden checkmate I'm not seeing?
What is going on, man? I traded a horse for a rook. You have done the same thing multiple times.
No, I have not. I traded a bishop with a knight.
How is that any different?
There is no actual way I have to break it down for you. Are you pulling my leg?
Quit talking to me like I'm a fucking child and tell me what I'm missing here.
Rooks are better than knights.
That's what you made a big deal over? That's not even a fact, it's just an opinion.
Actually, it is not an opinion. Rooks are worth 5 points of material, bishops and knights are worth 3.
Really? Well, I disagree with that judgment.
Am I hearing correctly? Are these words actually extruding from your lips?
Quit talking like someone from the Middle Ages, bitch. I have the right to an opinion.
It is not an opinion, it is a fallacy. Rooks are much stronger middle game, and they dominate the end game.
How so?
They're often used to deliver checkmates. They can link to each other, becoming super strong. They can travel the whole board. I could go on and on.
Last I checked, bishops do the same thing as rooks, just diagonally.
Bishops are limited to half the board. They are stuck on their color of origin. Bishops don't make a wall the king can't cross. The king can cross a bishop line of sight.
Whatever, I guess that makes sense.
I am on a roll this game. I have won every argument we've had.
That's only because Mike isn't here to back me up.
So you're saying the only way you can win an argument against me is if it's two against one?
No, Saul's usually on your side.
Saul is a buffoon. And every time he agrees with me, he's just being sarcastic or something. I don't think he has ever had a real opinion as an individual.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, what the fuck?
Ha! That queen blunder has given me the game. Thanks for the easy win, Jesse.
I'm just resigning. No need to continue this.
Oh, come on, man. Did you have to do that?
You literally won. Why are you upset?
Everyone knows it's more satisfying to win by checkmate.
Well, it was completely over for me, so why not just end it?
There's always a chance there will be a stalemate. The point is, I wanted to preform the winning move.
I never understood the stalemate. I mean, if one player is literally so pinned that they can't move, how is that a tie?
True shit. Like in real life, if that were to happen, the king would simply not move, and then the enemy would kill him on their next turn.
Agreed. Anyways, best 2 out of 3?
Bet, that was a short game. This next time you let me actually deliver a checkmate.
Fine, but I'm making the board, no fancy stuff.
I wonder how Mike is doing right now. You think he rescued Saul yet?
Oh, who in the world is at my door at 3:30 in the morning?
It's okay, baby girl. Mr. Funtime will be here waiting for you.
Who are you? What are you doing here at this hour?
I'm here to speak with Daniel.
Ugh, I knew I should have stopped him from texting his friends videos of us. Fine, I'll go get him. Daniel, an old bald guy, is here to see you.
Really? I thought I was done recording Boston cream pies.
What the fuck is a... Actually, I don't want to know.
I sit on a cream pie and wriggle around crying, then I... Coming. Hey, Mike, I'm guessing you found me from the video I sent you. Pretty hot, huh?
Daniel, Nacho stole your baseball cards again.
Seriously, that son of a biscuit. Why, I don't mean to be crude, but F that guy. We need to track him down immediately before they get damaged. Cheryl, I have got to go.
Daniel, can't you wait until tomorrow?
No, those cards are probably baking in his car as we speak. The increase in temperature and humidity can cause the images to fade. That is why I invested in my industrial AC.
Quiet, Daniel, get in my car and we'll get going.
Well, I guess since my time with Daniel was cut short, I'll go wake up my husband and sleep with him.
I wouldn't recommend that.
Why? It's not your business who I sleep with.
Well, you're going to find out sooner or later. You might as well.
Find out what?
Nothing. Have a good night, ma'am.
Seriously, Mr. White, you're using those bullshit pieces again.
What? You get to use those pieces your simple brain can handle, and my more intuitive one can use these pieces.
It's still hard for me to see what pieces of yours are what. Why do you have to use them? Why can't you just use normal fucking pieces?
Oh, give me a fucking break. Also, I'm very proud of you, Jesse, for responding with E5.
I only did it because it didn't work well for me last time, not because you told me not to use it. Also, how come you're white again? That's not fair.
Maybe it's because I am Mr. White.
Not gonna lie, that was good.
Jesse, are you seriously attempting to scholar's mate me?
What the fuck is a scholar's mate?
It's when you target F2 with your queen and your bishop right away to get a checkmate.
Well, yeah, that was what I was going for, but I guess you noticed it.
Jesse, in what world would I not notice it? How did you think that would work?
I don't know. It's worked against people before. I guess you're just better than who I usually play against.
It's actually worked for you before? Damn, that's embarrassing. Your ELO must be 200 or something pathetic such as that.
What is ELO?
You don't even know what ELO is?
Listen, you bitch. Every time I don't know something, you make it a big deal instead of just telling me what it is. Just fucking tell me from now on.
ELO is the ranking system for chess players on chess.com. My ELO is 1200, but only because I don't play chess that often. It is simply a hobby.
Well, there you go. I don't play online chess, so how would I know what ELO is?
Seriously? You only play over a board? What about right now?
This is the first time for me.
You really need to get on chess.com to try improving your ELO, Jesse.
Bitch, if I'm gonna play a video game, it's not gonna be chess. I only play chess with friends like right now. I'd never play against strangers. That sounds boring.
Oh, really? What game would you play if you were by yourself, then?
I don't often game by myself, but when I do, it's usually COD.
Jesse, how is playing against strangers in COD any different from playing against strangers in chess?
I don't know, it just is. Get off my back, man.
Oh, damn, I should have noticed that piece was hanging.
Looks like we'll be playing 3 games of chess tonight.
Nonsense. I'm still going to pull ahead and win. This is our last game of chess.
Okay, we'll see about that.
Thanks for the free pawn, Jesse.
Shoot, didn't see that. Whatever, it's just a pawn.
Jesse, did you seriously learn nothing from my lecture about pawns?
I don't think I have ever learned anything from your lectures, especially your lectures back in high school.
You say that like it was my fault when you clearly didn't apply yourself and focus on cultivating your mind.
Cultivate this!
You know, Jesse, you might as well just resign to save us both some time. You will fail at chess just like you failed at my class.
Bitch, I thought you were completely against resigning. Wait a minute, what is this?
What is what?
Ha! Get checkmated, you crusty-ass nerd.
What are... No, I refuse to believe it.
Damn, you're right. It does feel better delivering checkmate rather than getting a resignation.
No, this is bullshit. You used Stockfish, didn't you?
What is Stockfish?
Good try trying to play dumb. You know full well what Stockfish is because you using it is the only way you could have beaten me.
Bitch, I'm not a cheater. It was you who cheated in Scrabble. If anything, I should be accusing you of cheating the first game given your track record.
This was just a fluke then. A broken clock is right twice a day.
If it was just a fluke, then you will have no problem beating me in the next game.
You're right, I won't.
Jesse, can you keep it down? I'm trying to... What is Brock doing up at this hour?
Oh, Andrea, hey, me and Brock were just hanging out.
It's Brock and I, dumbass.
Excuse me, has Brock been subjected to this kind of language this whole time?
No, this fucking retard just doesn't know when to shut up.
I do not want you talking like that in front of my son. And I do not want you to have him playing games with people that talk like that, Jesse.
Oh, no, it's cool. He hasn't played anything. He has just been watching.
Are you kidding me? You keep him up 5 hours past his bedtime and you don't even let him play. You just make him sit there and watch? Jesse, this is unacceptable.
He's cool with it, right, Brock? Well, you know him. He doesn't talk much.
Brock, you need to go to bed. And Jesse, you and I need to have a serious talk, so get off that game.
You can't, Jesse. We have to have our tiebreaker round.
Andrea, I just need to play one more game of chess to finish the best 2 out of 3. And I think Brock is pretty interested. You should let him stay.
Fine, I'll go make a pot of coffee. This is going to be a long talk. Right after you're done, send Brock to bed and meet me in the kitchen.
Jesse, this isn't good. If you're up all night talking, how will you have enough energy for tomorrow?
I have no idea, man. These talks can last hours. I might not do too well tomorrow.
This is bullshit. You're on my team tomorrow. I can't have a sleepy team member.
I'll have a Red Bull. It'll be fine. Finally, I get to be white, and it's in the round that matters the most, too.
Well, if you can win with black, I sure as hell can.
Hey, watch the language around Brock. I don't want him repeating these words near Andrea.
Oh, come on. Brock literally never talks. He said like 2 words over the course of our show. How do you think I got away with poisoning him for so long?
That's true. And he wasn't even the one that revealed it. What the fuck? How is that a checkmate?
I cannot believe I actually fools mated you.
How is a checkmate that fast even possible?
There is literally only one series of moves that can have this result. And you're such an idiot that you did them without meaning to.
This is bullshit.
I can cross that one off the bucket list. I have always wanted to pre-form a fool's mate.
I guess it's for the best it ended so quickly. Don't want to keep Andrea waiting. It'll just make her more upset.
Well, no, we can still play something. She probably allotted 10 minutes for you to finish your game, so how about we... Hey, honey, how was it at Ted's place?
I fucked Ted.
Holy shit, Skylar, I know. You don't have to tell me every night when you get home.
I just want to make it clear. Anyways, you know how I feel about you gaming with your... business associates.
Oh, come on, Sky, just 10 more minutes.
No, you will not game in our house, at least not with them. You're already a bad influence on the kids. No need to have these good-for-nothings do the same.
Put this bitch on the mic, Mr. White, so we can have a few words.
No, it's fine, Jesse. You have to go talk to Andrea anyways. Try to get as much sleep as possible. See you tomorrow.
See you, Mr. White.